which is equal and opposite, क्योंकि coin तो वही है, coin वही है, और मुझे justify करना है कि F is equal to MA काम करता है, F is equal to MA works for the person who is sitting on this platform. So what do I say? The coin is experiencing right now. The coin is experiencing what force? Which force? Apart from the force inwards, it is experiencing an outward radial force, radially outward force, and we like to call that force as
centrifugal.
Centrifugal force, हाँ, जो कि हमें बहुत ही अच्छा लगता है, centrifugal force. So we have this centrifugal force over here, which is acting. And now the coin is stationary. The coin is stationary. So centrifugal force exists for whom? Centrifugal force exists for whom? Does it exist for me, who I'm standing here? Does it exist for me? No. Does it exist for the person who is sitting on the platform?
Yes.
So centrifugal force for me has no existence. Centrifugal force for the person who is sitting on the platform has a existence. Do you agree with me? Okay. Now, supposing I increase the velocity, of the rotating platform. I increase the velocity of the rotating platform. Now, what will happen to the coin? If I increase the velocity of the platform, then उसे coin को कैसे घूमना है? गोल गोल घूमना है? उसे क्या चाहिए? कोई भी चीज को अगर घूमना है तो it needs a force inwards. वो कौन provide करता है? Who's providing that? Static friction. So, but static friction, can it be increased to any value? No. At some point of time, it's going to give up. कि नहीं, मेरे से नहीं होता है. Static friction says, बस, that's my limit. After that, what happens? Who wins? There are two forces acting. एक centrifugal force बाहर की तरफ, एक static friction अंदर की तरफ. If I increase the speed, who wins? The centrifugal force. So now, what happens to the coin? What does the coin want to do? Okay. The force which wins will cause the coin to move radially outward. So that's what I'm going to do. I will move this platform and then see whether the coin is going outward or not. So I'll increase the speed this time and I'll... Okay. I got what I wanted. I hope when I stop it, it doesn't change. So anyway, Now I'd like to show you the trail of. I would like to show you that the speed was not so much. You know, aata bhi ud jata hai saath mein. So here you can see that it was supposed to go. It was supposed to go radially outward. Who was winning? Who was to win? Centrifugal force, it was supposed to go radially outward, but you can see that radially outward ke saath saath there is a movement in this direction also. There is a tangential movement also along with the radial direction. Now over here, who caused it? Hamare paas to do hai forces se.
कल वाला हो गया.
So if anything is moving radially, what does it mean? If anything is moving radially outwards or having a velocity in a radial direction on a rotating platform, then it will experience a force also in a tangential direction. And this force is the Coriolis force. So that is what you are seeing. That the trail which you are seeing over here is not straight over here. It is curving. And it is a very, very important force, Coriolis force. Agar koi cheez rotating platform pe, it wants to go radially outward, then it experiences a tangential force. And if something wants to go tangentially, I make the coin somehow move with respect to the rotating platform in a circular path. Then opposite will happen. It will experience a force in the radial direction. तो कोई चीज अगर radially चलने की कोशिश कर रही है तो उसको force feel होगा, वो इधर इधर चली जाएगी. और कोई चीज ऐसे ऐसे जा रही है तो वो इधर इधर जाने की कोशिश करेगी. सो इट्स लाइक कि आप जहाँ जाने की कोशिश कर रहे हो उससे थोड़ा सा अलग हमको फोर्स मिल रही है ओवर हियर. एंड दिस इज बेसिकली डिपेंडिंग अपॉन क्रॉस प्रोडक्ट ऑफ ओमेगा एंड ई. सो यू नो अबाउट द कोरिओलिस फोर्सेस. सो ओमेगा क्रॉस वी gives us the direction of the Coriolis force. So omega, if I'm rotating it like this, what's omega? Direction of omega kya hai? Niche ki taraf. Okay, downward. And if the coin was moving radially outward, this is the downward direction. And if it is moving radially outward, then this is the direction of the vector outward. So over here, omega cross v ke liye, it experiences a force in this direction. Okay? It experiences a force tangential. So agar aisi hai velocity, aisi radially outward hai velocity, then you are getting a force like this. Aur agar aisi hai velocity aur ye omega hai, let's say ye omega hai aur ye hai velocity, this is tangential. Then the force is radial. Okay. So Coriolis force is responsible for a lot of things on Earth, especially the air currents and all. Geography में हम पढ़ाते हैं बच्चों को कि वो एक zone से दूसरे zone में the winds, how they travel, trade winds, and even the water currents. They are affected by the Coriolis force, and Coriolis force is the reason why the earth is maintaining a particular temperature. So it's not like somewhere it is very very hot and somewhere it's cold, although it is, but still there is some balancing act done because of Coriolis force. Okay, so now let us